tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
What up, man?
Never told him back with my brother and it together.
Don't hit too low, no, I need my legs. Coach, we sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone, long for a defense.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football and Big D, as their guys will do battle with the New York Jets. Greg Zuerlein's got it teed up, and off we go from Arlington. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
But from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three 3-yard gains, that means they'll punt the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Carter with it. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Give them five on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down. So, Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Now Carter. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. The safety, Keanu Neal, there to make the tackle.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 42 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. Now a first and 10 at the 11. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. On the tackle, it's Randy Gregory. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Wilson. They'll set up the screen to Carter. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. The 13th play now coming on this opening drive. Here's third down. They'll run with Carter. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
Going for it, it's Carter. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Michael Carter, a three-yard touchdown run. And the Jets take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Where's 52? Where's 52? 52's the mic. I'm here all day. I'm here all day.
They start on the ground with Elliott. Oh, what a move. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Elliott running right. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
A first down carry by Elliott. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Left side to Lamb. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. The give is to Elliott. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
You know, it was tough for them to stand on the sidelines and watch the other team take it downfield and score, wasn't it? So they knew when they got on the field, it's on them. Pick up first downs, get downfield and score. How about them picking up that 3rd and short?
I was just going to say, you and I were talking before the game, those 3rd down conversions are going to be huge in this one. They'll go with Pollard here on 1st down. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Lamb. 2nd quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis on this first half. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On 2nd down, Elliott once more, and he'll go down at the 28. They'll run on 1st down. It's Elliott down to the 25. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Here's Prescott. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. Creeping up on 1 minute to play in this first half. 10th carry now for Elliott. Trucks over him. And he's able to pick up the 1st down before he's tackled right at the 10. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. A nice display of power, but it only takes him to the 7. He's dropped there. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Elliott, toss right. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he'll get in. And they take an 8-7 lead. Well, they got down 7-0. They said, we'll go for 2, one up you, and they take the lead.
How about that for a little risk-reward, right? If you don't get it, you're only down a point. Let's go ahead and make a statement in this ball game, and that's exactly what they did.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's 2nd down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
To throw again on 2nd down, Wilson. Over the middle, complete. It's Carter. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now it's Wilson. That's complete. It's Elijah Moore. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. They go play action now. Wilson. He's going to throw one up for the end zone. Got a man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Elijah Moore. In the final seconds of the first half, and the Jets are going to retake the lead. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
The extra point up and good. And that makes this a 14-8 ball game. So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Play of the half, Prescott eluding the pressure right. He'll have a 1st down pass. And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. And this one will actually go out of bounds, so no recovery. And that is how we conclude this first half. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the 3rd quarter. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Tackle made by Foley Fadukasi, the former UConn Husky. Coming up on a 2nd and 6. Now Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. First down, Prescott. Again, it's Cooper as he makes the catch. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So in jet territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 46. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. And again, it's Prescott. And he is caught by Lamb. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 27-yard line. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. And this one nearly intercepted. Boy, that would have been a great time for their first pick. But instead, it's 3rd down. 7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Now Prescott. Open man Lamb, it's complete. And the Cowboys are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. Now Mike McCarthy going to decide to go for 2 here. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of 2-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
From the 24, Wilson is brought in by Jamison Crowder. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. Heavy set out there on 3rd and 1. Here's a give to Carter. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. They'll run. It's Carter. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on 2nd down. Here's Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Carter. And he is going to have a Jets first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Try the right side, and he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From just shy of midfield, Wilson over the middle and into the hands of his receiver Moore. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Handoff for Carter. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. On first down, right back to Carter. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play, and it'll be 3rd and 10 now. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On 3rd down, Wilson. He'll get that one to Carter complete. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. That's going to bring up 4th down. Only a gain of 2 there. And now this defense trying to use the clock to their advantage. They'll take the timeout here with 2:08 left. And then they'll have another stop coming up at the 2-minute warning. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And they take a 17-14 lead. So they hadn't called on him at all until this point, but he comes through here and buries one from long range.
Yeah, that's awfully impressive, because usually kickers like to get that first one out of their system in the first quarter, sort of get them into the flow of the game. But to come in this late and knock it down from long distance, give him a lot of credit.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's Dak. Into the hands of Cooper. 7 yards, the pickup there. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now Prescott. Right back to Cooper, and he got him again. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Prescott. Looking for Cooper, that's complete. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Now Dak. He'll get this to Elliott. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. And that's good for a gain of 6. And it'll bring up a second down. To throw, Prescott. Completes it right side to Cooper.
Hey, you got your first down. Get up to the line of scrimmage and spike it.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Sliding out of the pocket. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. Here's Prescott. He'll buy some time right. A dump off to Elliott. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down. Prescott to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. It'll be a gain of just a yard, and that'll bring up fourth down.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. It may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Running with Elliott, and he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And it would appear they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Here's Coleman now to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short of the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph.